Let's start with this scripture. This is found in the book of Luke, chapter 21, verse 25, where Jesus was talking about all these different apocalyptic signs of the end of the age. And he said these words in verse 25, "There shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars, and upon the earth distress of nations with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring, and men's hearts fail in them for fear, for looking after those things that are coming upon the earth. For the powers of heaven shall be shaken. Then shall they see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. And when these things begin to come to pass, then look up, lift up your head, your redemption is drawing nigh." Pastor, here we are, another prophetic sign tonight, a blood moon, but not just any blood moon, 3.5 hours. This is the longest one in like 600 years or something. What does this mean? Well, you've been doing, you know, God gives you a lot of revelation. Tell us what you see about this blood moon.
Sure. This is so significant because, as you also know, from Genesis 1, 14 and 15, God said he specifically put the sun and the moon and the stars in the sky for signs. Number one reason was for signs. And the problem is the church isn't schooled in the signs. Now, the devil pushes astrology. God wants nothing to do with astrology.
Right.
It's biblical astronomy.
Amen.
And the difference is astrology, you make it all about you. No, I'm sorry. It's not about you. Biblical astronomy is it's all about him.
Amen.
And that's why it says in Psalms, the heavens declare the glory of God and the firmament is handiwork. So for me, it's go God. And I love looking at the sky and looking at him, what it proclaims about him. And when he specifically says he put them for signs, our job is to find out what do these signs mean. Well, the most specific sign would be an eclipse. Well, the way God set up the biblical calendar was so that the beginning of a month was a new moon. And you can only have a solar eclipse at a new moon.
Right.
And then you can only have a lunar eclipse on a full moon, which is why Passover and Tabernacles are at the full moon.
Right.
So that he could connect the signs with the events in history that are happening. And you had mentioned what happened about this time, 168 BC?
Yeah, 167 BC, there was the Grecians came to Jerusalem. They already had been creeping around, but they went right up on the Temple Mount, right on the brazen altar, and they sacrificed pigs, hogs, other unclean animals to their pagan gods. They committed what's known as an abomination of desolation. So that happened on this very night that many years ago. Are you serious?
Are you serious? I mean, this was mind-blowing when I heard this, because This is Kislev. It's the month of Hanukkah.
Oh.
And that's what was going on in 167. It was the whole events of Hanukkah.
Oh.
And Matthew 24 is about Hanukkah happening again. And this is what Christians don't understand. Matthew 24, Hanukkah is going to repeat. And so here we have this blood moon on Hanukkah, and the whole story of Hanukkah is the battle against assimilation. It's a battle against light versus darkness. They wanted to do away with the Torah, the Bible. They wanted to not allow them to do anything to keep their faith. So it was a battle against the faith in the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Wow.
Now, this is the battle of Hanukkah, but here's the other thing. Messiah was also conceived during Hanukkah.
That's true.
He was
That's
born true. On the Feast of Tabernacles, but he was conceived during Hanukkah. And guess what? It was in the middle of Hanukkah, Noah's flood rain stopped and the rainbow first appeared. That was a sign in the heavens also.
I didn't know that one. Okay.
Yeah, Noah's, okay. You count 40 days, it takes you right to the middle of Hanukkah is when the rainbow occurred. Now, this time of year is the darkest time of year. And so God always wants to put the biggest sign right at the biggest time of year. And speaking of the battle, in Jeremiah 31, it was during Hanukkah that Baruch read Jeremiah's warning to King Jehoiakim, and he cut it into leaves and he threw it into the fireplace, disregarding the word of the Lord. That happened at this time.
Oh, no.
Exactly at this time. And what's amazing in my book, Jeremiah, as they were throwing the word of the Lord into the fire, that's when the word of the Lord appeared in the fire in Babylon to save the three Hebrew children. The same time.
No. I didn't know that. So here we go. Because he's the God of the fire. He's the God of the flood.
He is the fire of the word. Amen. In Jerusalem, they throw the word of the fire. The word of the Lord in the fire, and in Babylon, the word of the Lord appears in the fire, saving the three Hebrew children.
Wow. Same time. I didn't know that.
Same time. Hey, you can go back and look. This is incredible. This is during Hanukkah. But now here's the most mind-blowing thing. This is the one that is just going to set everybody off. Are you ready?
I can't hardly. My heart's skipping. Tell me, what? I'm having palpitations. Go ahead.
Okay, Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 5 through 7. It talks about the tribulation. Okay, and it says, a voice of shaking fear has come to our ears, a fear and not a peace. Put the question to see if it's possible for a man to have birth pains. Why do I see every man with his hands gripping his side as a woman does when the pains of birth are on her? Alas, the day is great. There's no day like it. It is the time of Jacob's trouble.
Yes.
Okay, so right here, it's talking about the time of Jacob's trouble.
Yes.
Now, that's Jeremiah 30. The very next chapter, the New Covenant, Jeremiah 31, in verse 15 through 17, it talks about how there's a sound of crying and weeping, bitter sorrow. Rachel is weeping for her children and won't be comforted.
Yes.
Okay, so you're familiar with that verse.
Oh, yes.
Now, are you ready for this? Here we go.
Okay.
It so happens that the Torah portion this weekend speaks of the birth of Benjamin and the death of Rachel.
This weekend, the Torah portion
that they read. Everyone reads about Rachel weeping, calling her son Ben-Oni, which means son of my sorrow, referring to Messiah's first coming, the man of sorrow. And then Jacob saying, no, he's Benjamin, son of my right hand. Okay, which refers to his second coming.
Right.
And here, this month of Kislev is the month of Benjamin. And it's this very weekend, the eclipse takes place, and it's the very Torah portion when this event happens that Benjamin dies and Rachel dies and Benjamin is born. This weekend.
This weekend.
This eclipse is happening this weekend.
Which is also the very Torah portion that's being read this weekend all over the world.
Yes,
And this is when it happened.
The month of Benjamin. Yeah, exactly.
And we're having a blood moon to signify it, to prophetically, really to show us that what has been will be. Remember, they could hear Rachel weeping at the time. Then when Christ was born, they could hear Rachel weeping for the children. And now you're saying on the anniversary of that weekend, they're also going to read this. I mean, they're going to read this as the Torah portion. And we got a blood moon.
For the month of Benjamin, Kislev 15. And it's the very weekend Benjamin is born. And Rachel died.
You can't make this stuff up. I mean, this is huge, because God is confirming his word again. He's confirming his word again. And also, he's giving us a sign that the Jacob's trouble. Let's go back over there to, you're just saying, Revelation 30. He's saying in verse 7, alas, for the day is great. But why? Because we have heard a voice of trembling, of fear, and not of peace. We ask you now, and see whether a man doth travail with child. Whether do I see every man with his hands on his loins as a woman in travail, and all faces are turned into paleness? They're in severe pain. And for the day is great, so that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble. So it's Jacob's trouble. It's the
Rachel's dying.
She dies. Benjamin's born. It's the very month and weekend it happened. And God says, how about a blood moon? Okay, which signifies you always huge events with it relates to Israel. Am I correct on that?
Totally. And I believe, again, that it is so long because God wants us really to contemplate the meaning of this.